we're ready to start. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for coming to our winter concert, Movies and Musicals. Most of the songs you're going to hear tonight are from Movies and Musicals. A couple are not. They're actually leftovers from the fall concert that we didn't have time to learn. So I thought we'd stick them in on this concert as well. My name is Jerry Martunek. I am the director of the Northam 28 Children's Choir. And up here we have our third grade group ready to perform for you. Quick note before we get started. In the back, I have a wonderful tech operator. Her name is Julia, and she's in fifth grade. And she is doing tech for this show for the first time tonight. She has never had a run-through with this group. I scribbled a whole bunch of notes for her, and I'm so excited to have her back there. So can we give Julia a round of applause? Without further ado, let's get started with tonight's show.
Do you know?
thank you so much. For our next piece, Kaylin came up to me after last week and said that she has a pale pink coat. And can she wear it for this song? And I said, sure, why not? Because that would be awesome. So here is The Lonely Goatherd along with Kaylin's pale pink coat. Things about doing a show without movies and musicals is a lot of the songs are familiar, which means that oftentimes they're quite a bit more difficult than we had thought. For this next one, everybody thinks we don't know Hakuna Matata. We've seen the movie multiple times. And then we opened up the music, and was it as easy as we thought?
No,
not even close. Part of the reason they changed some of the order for the arrangements, but also just realizing how many different pitches and rhythms and things actually make up these songs. It's a really great opportunity to learn that, like, even though these are songs we all know and we've been singing since we were quite young, there's still a lot to learn in them. I hope you enjoy our last piece, Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata, a wonderful prayer.
We're going to do a really quick switch here. Third grade, I don't know, first. Once they get off the stage, fourth grade, come on up and head in. But just wait for them to clear out of here just a little bit. While we're waiting, again, thank you so much for coming. I want to mention really quickly the Wheelchair Foundation. We do a fundraiser at every concert for the Wheelchair Foundation. And for $150, they'll donate a chair to someone in a third world country who needs it. And I even have ours that we got at our last concert. We were able to raise just over $150. And now a young child, I'm not sure if it's a boy or a girl, a young child in Iraq now has a wheelchair thanks to your generosity. So thank you so much for that. If you feel like donating again on your way out, right at the table right there, we have a couple collection boxes. If everybody tosses in a dollar or two, we'll easily get up to $150. And then we get this nice little folder that says, thanks to the Northbrook 28 Children's Choir 2019 Fall Concert. I do get all of these framed. I'm sure you've seen them in the hallway going out there. I've had to stop briefly because we are out of space and Greenbrier to put them up, so we're looking for another place. We've raised quite a bit of money so far, which is awesome. So if you have any extra change or a dollar or two on your way out, please consider donating to the Wheelchair Foundation. And here comes the fourth grade. That's my fault. We're coming in exactly backwards of what we should be. So, just go over there, find your spot. All right. Our first song tonight is This Old Man. I was teaching this one, I started it in the fall, and I had the realization that the Barney song, the opening one, Barney is a dinosaur, is Yankee Doodle. And I realized that the closing song to Barney, I love you, you love me, is a slower version of This Old Man. And now I can't get it out of my head. This old man, he played one, we're a happy band. But this is a really fun arrangement of This Old Man.
This song.
This next song starts off with a solo from Lexi. Where's Lexi? Lexi, come on. And Julia, who's running tech in the back for the first time, the solo's at the beginning. Once she's done, you can mute the microphone.
Hello.
A couple quick announcements coming up. Our last concert is on Tuesday, May 19th. This concert we had 12 rehearsals to prepare for, and the next one I think we have 8. So here we go. The only days we do not rehearse is April 29th and 30th. That is a Wednesday and Thursday for 4th and 5th grade, because that is the day of the 5th grade musical at Greenbrier and Meadowbrook and Westmore. And this, our stage is going to look like a circus. But we will not be rehearsing on the days that our 5th graders have their musical performances, because I will be putting on makeup. Well, I won't be putting on makeup. I will be helping the kids put on makeup and get into costume and microphones and all that other stuff. But that's the only day, and then we will be finished after May 19th. If you are in 3rd or 4th grade, if you are a parent of a 3rd or 4th grader, 4th grade, keep moving in. You need the 5th grade to get out. Keep an eye out in your email after spring break for information about next year for choir. We're changing it up just a little bit. We're going to still have 3 groups. One group is going to be for 3rd graders and 1st time 4th graders, so that'll be nobody in this room. Another group will be for 4th graders and 1st time 5th graders and 2nd time 5th graders, and then we're going to be doing an audition only 4th and 5th grade group. More information about that will be coming out, like I said, after spring break in the beginning of April, so keep an eye out for that. And here come the 5th grade. In the same style of Hakuna Matata, we've learned that Disney songs are quite a bit more difficult than we thought they were. How is Under the Sea more difficult than you thought it would be?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many of you thought you knew this song before we started? How many of you know this song now? All right, good. Here we go with Under the Sea.
Yeah.
This next piece, Somewhere Out There from An American Tale, features Sean Harden.
Julia, this solo is at the beginning.
Some
Our last piece for you is not from a musical. This is actually the first song we started learning the very first time this group met. I shelved it after a couple weeks. It needed a little more work than we had time for the fall concert, so we brought it back out for this one. And this is going to feature a solo by Cecily. Let's come on up and check the mic out. And Julia, this solo's in the middle. So, watch for her to come up. And when she comes up, unmute that microphone. Now it's time for the fourth graders and the third graders to come back up and join us. Fifth grade, if we can slide that way. Everybody else, if you look at the back of your program, you'll see some music. This is the part where you get to sing and join us. If you were here for our concert last time, this is the same song we did at the end. This will be our closing song. It's called Two Music. And you'll notice above all of the pitches, I wrote the solfege in there for you. So if you know how to read solfege, there you go. This is the way that we learn all of our songs, is through solfege. So I give the kids their starting pitch, and we sing through it. So, do, re, mi, mi. I don't really play it on the piano for them. There's not a lot of echoing. It's a lot of, let's sit down and figure out how this works. So, we'll give you a little break. We'll do it one time for you on solfege, and then we all want to hear how good you can do it. So like I said, we'll sing it for you through once on solfege so you can get it in your ear, and then we'll all sing together.
Thank you.
go, so...
Should we have them do it?
Yeah!
But what we do need is to eat our pasta. What's B stand for?
Posture.
You can't sing sitting down. It's not good posture. What's A? Air. S is... T. Don't hang. Articulation. All right. So please join us in singing our final song to music. Dismiss them first. Some of them have jackets in my room. We can get them. Then head up the stairs to where the front entrance is. Go all the way down by the restrooms where we take our bathroom break. There's plenty of space down there for you to reconnect with your parents. Third grade, head on out.